This is René for networklessons.com. And in this video, you will learn about the OSPF Hello Packet. Yeah? So when you configure OSPF on routers, then the router will start sending hello packets. Yeah? When you send hello packets and you receive them, then the routers will try to become neighbors. Yeah? Now in this hello packet, you will find a lot of stuff. Yeah? So let's walk through this list that you will find in the hello packet. Yeah? First of all, there's something called the router ID. Yeah? Each OSPF router has a unique router ID. Now, where does the router ID come from? First of all, if you have a loopback interface, then the router will take the IP address of the loopback as its router ID. Yeah? If you don't have a loopback, then it will just pick the highest IP address on any active interface. Yeah? So normally, IP addresses are unique within the network. You don't configure the same IP address on multiple interfaces. So by selecting the IP address as a router ID, each router should have a unique router ID. Okay. The next one, hello and dead interval. And I put a blue asterisk behind it, which means that these two values, this is something that has to match on both routers or you won't become neighbors. Yeah. So what is it, hello and dead interval? The hello interval means that, for example, we send an hello packet each 5 seconds or something. Yeah. So maybe this router is sending the hello packet each 5 seconds and R2 is sending it each 10 seconds. Yeah. Then we have a mismatch and these two routers won't become neighbors. Yeah. So we have to agree on how often we send hello packets. Yeah. The dead interval means that if I don't receive any hello packets from you for a certain while, then I'm going to declare you dead and we are no longer neighbors. Yeah? And this dead interval has to match on both sides. Okay, what else will we find? The neighbors. So what other neighbors do I have? That's what you will find in the hello packet. We have to agree on the area ID. Yeah? So what area you are in. Yeah? So if I'm going to configure these two routers, then they have to agree that they are in the same area. Okay? And of course, this has to match. So the next three items, the router priority, DR and BDR. Yeah? The designated router IP, you will see it in the hello packet, and the backup designated router. And the router priority is used to determine who will become DR or BDR. Now, normally this is a default value. So if you don't set the priority, then the router ID will determine who will become DR or BDR. Yeah? This is something you will find in the hello packet. What else do we have? Authentication and a password. So by default, there is no authentication. But if you want, you can enable plain text or you can enable MD5 authentication. And of course, this has to match. So if you do plain text here and here MD5, then you will have a mismatch. So make sure you use the same authentication type on both sides and you use the same password. Yeah? Last but not least, the stub area flag. Well, OSPF has special area types. And there's a stub area and there's a totally stub and not so stubby area. And these are all special area types. And if you're studying CCNA, then you don't have to worry about these. But for CCNP, you have to know about them. But if you're using any of the special area types, then we have to agree that we are using the same area type. Yeah? So that's something that has to match. So if so you can see the hello dead interval have to match, area ID, authentication, password, and the stub area flag. If these values do not match, then we will not become neighbors. If it does match, we will become neighbors, and then we can continue with the LSA flooding and so on. Yeah? So I hope this helps to understand the hello packet, and it might be fun to boot up your routers, start up Wireshark and take a look at a hello packet yourself. That might be an interesting exercise. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching and I'll see you next time.